Hey, Canucks fans, I'm Clay Emo. I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter. I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCBC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club. And it's my Canucks take all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Monday, March the 16th. It's day one of spring break. It's day five of no NHL hockey. And today I wanted to take a temperature check. And not necessarily a physical temperature check, although you should do that if you're not feeling well, but more of a emotional, mental, intellectual, temperature check. I want to see how you guys are doing. Because I admit, I'm a little restless right now. I didn't have a good night of sleep. And I think as I was praying and I was thinking about everything that's going on in the world, obviously with the COVID-19 virus, coronavirus, and more deaths and more, you know, the talk about social distancing and all these things and how things may affect the workplace and gatherings, public gatherings and so on and so forth. I admit I was a little restless. And maybe it's also because I didn't want to sleep in and miss my interview on Sportsnet 650, which I'll talk about in a second. But so I got up at 5 o'clock in the morning, showered. And I actually came to work by 6:30 so I could take my 7 o'clock phone call for the interview here at work instead of on my cell. And it's made for an early start to the day for me. I'm not sure what's going to happen here at work. So before I talk about anything hockey stuff, just an admission that I am a little restless right now. And I'm worried and I'm concerned for our society, for the elderly, for the world overall, and just are people reacting as well as they should? Are they making the smart decisions as they should? And I'm not here to judge, but we can all do our part. So I ask you to really do your best to make those good decisions when it comes to social distancing and going out or not going out and what kind of activities you're doing. There's so much information out there, a lot of misinformation out there. I don't even know if I'm reading and watching the right stuff, but I do know that I have to always intentionally try and make good decisions with respect to myself, my own health, and of course, the health of my family. Not only my immediate family, but my loved ones as well. So yeah, it's a tricky time right now, and we expect to hear some major announcements from the federal government, provincial government today that may even further limit how much we can do when it comes to going out, being entertained, and socially as well. Now, when it comes to this channel, I realize there's going to be a struggle to find relevant things to talk about, but I don't want to force videos either. So not that anyone are waiting for a daily video, but I'm really going to kind of take it as it goes. I don't want to record just for the sake of recording, but I will seek out, obviously, Vancouver Canucks specific stories, anything we hear about players or their families, whatever it may be, about the organization, such as Francesco Anchilini basically tweeting out yesterday that a member of Canucks Sports and Entertainment, but not a member of the front-facing Rogers Arena hockey staff, but a member of CSE, Canucks Sports Entertainment, has been tested positive for COVID-19. Not sure why they had to make that announcement. Maybe it's for the sake of transparency. Maybe because they want to be the first ones out before someone else reported it. But I think there's a lot of people that have it. It's just the way it goes that we don't know about that right now, or maybe they're not showing symptoms until it's too late. And you don't know that you have it and then you spread it. It's not your fault, but that's how these things spread, right? So it's very tricky. So as I was saying, see, I'm all over the place, you can tell. As I was saying, I won't force these videos, but I will look for Canuck-specific stories, NHL-specific stories, sports-related stories, whether it's coronavirus or not, things that are relevant that I want to keep this channel going and at least updating it relatively regularly, like I said, without forcing it. Don't forget, tonight, I didn't do it last night because of a scheduling change, but I will be going on YouTube tonight live at 10 o'clock for my weekly live stream. We won't have any hockey to talk about. I would have loved to talk about a win in Arizona, a win in Colorado, and a win at home against Winnipeg. Three straight wins, 6 points to vault the Canucks back into third place in the Pacific Division. But obviously we can't do that. But I would invite you to join me on YouTube at 10 o'clock tonight for my weekly live stream. And for those who saw my Twitter poll, I was trying to get my whole family on there, but I don't think it's going to work tonight. But I'm going to try and get at least get my daughter Kayla on once as well, along with one of the two boys, or if not both boys. But we'll figure that out as we go. Today, I want to talk about a couple things really quickly. They're both related. Ultimately, I want to talk about some of my musical collaborations with my lovely and talented collab partner, Marie Huey. And I bring this up because this morning we were on Sportsnet 650, the starting lineup with James Cybulski and Perry Solkowski. And we were on between about 7:05 to 7:20, so about a 14 or 15 minute hit. And it was really good. It was wasn't the toughest interview ever, but it was a wonderful opportunity. So I'm very grateful to Sportsnet 650, to James and to Perry for having Marie and me on this morning. And we talked mostly, almost exclusively, or entirely about music and about writing parody songs, Marie's anthem, the way how we met, how long we've known each other, how what's the process behind writing a parody song. It's pretty cool, actually. I love talking about these kind of things. And we also talked about it on the Larshcast last week with Tej and the boys on the Larshcast podcast, and then we were able to talk about a similar thing this morning. And I think it's a cool story, not just because I'm in it, but I think anytime you have a chance to express your fandom in a creative way, whether it's through vlogging or through writing haiku or through writing parody songs, I think it's a neat little story. And we talked about the excitement and the notoriety we get in a good way, and how you know, my inspirations behind the parody song. So I'll post that link when it becomes available, probably later today. But like I said, thank you to James, to Perry, and to Sportsnet 650 crew for having us on. And I love doing these parody songs. You guys know I've counted on my YouTube playlist, there's 35 Vancouver Canucks songs. That doesn't include Seattle Seahawks songs, Vancouver Whitecaps songs, church songs, popular pop cover, Toronto Raptors songs, whatever it may be. But we've done 35 Vancouver Canucks songs over the past 9 years, and 22 of them involve Marie Huey. So 22 out of 35, that's a points percentage of about 0.629. So Marie has appeared in 63% of my Canucks parody songs. And I love the process of picking a song and then writing some lyrics. And I talked about it this morning. The most magical thing is when I write these lyrics and then Marie walks into my house and we're sitting at my piano fooling around. I hand her the lyrics for the first time and she starts to sing them. And it's like magic. It's amazing. I almost stopped playing because it's beautiful hearing Marie's awesome and powerful voice. And then she'll go and we'll take pen to paper and we'll kind of tweak some of the phrasing so it's more singable, because when I write, I don't think about what's singable. I just try and match the syllables to the actual song. And I think that's the key of a good parody song, is you want it to sound very similar to the original. You want it to be singable like the original. You want to be able to recognize what song it is. So any lyrics that are similar, that are cleverly connected to the original song, that helps a lot. And everything from the title to the chorus to the pre-chorus to the verses, those of you who do music, play music, write music, you'll know what I'm talking about. Just the way the phrasing, the cadencing of the words, it makes a big difference. And I think that's what separates my good parody songs from my not so good, is how recognizable it is and how closely it relates to the original song. Then of course Marie looks at the lyrics, she sings them through a couple times, she makes tweaks here and there to make it more singable and to make it make sense. And then we kind of go from there. And it's a really, really neat process. And sometimes we do it all in one take, sitting at my piano in my living room. And it's kind of a very, very raw, kind of organic type feel. And I think that's what was kind of the appeal to these songs when you first started. And now we've been using producers like my brother Jason. We've been working with Canucks producers for some of our songs. So very blessed to have those opportunities as well. So I love both. I love the goofy one-take wonders at my piano, and I love the back and forth Brady Bunch, 53 Horvat Magic, Christmas songs that we work on with the Canucks as well, using their sound guys, their video guys, their editing people. So it's way better than what I can produce from home. So all in all, I'm very grateful for the opportunity. I'm grateful that I have the ability to write music and write lyrics pretty quick. Sometimes it only takes me 15 to 20 minutes to write a song, but obviously I can't sing. And that's why I bring in people like Marie and others who are very good singers, who are Canucks fans. And they make, Marie especially, makes anything sound really, really good. And it's kind of cool. The very first time Marie and I worked on a parody was actually 9 years ago. It was the fall of 2011. I was trying to win this Replace the KB, the curtain blog, Mike Halford and Jason Bruff. They were, the first time they were leaving the province, they actually ran a contest and to find people to replace them. And everyone was pulling out the big guns, you know, their best writing, their best graphic design. So I brought in Marie and we did a parody way back in the day. In fact, I'm gonna link it to this video because it's kind of funny to see how far we've come. So this was November of 2011 and we did a parody that had three songs. It had Michael Jackson's Man in the Mirror, but it was about the defense, so I'm starting with the man in the rear, I think it was. And then it was Katy Perry's Fireworks, and we talked about David Booth there, remember him? And then it was Adele's Rolling in the Deep, and I can't remember what we ended up singing for that. We could have had it all rolling in the, I can't remember. But I'll post the, that was 9 years ago. I'll post it, but that was kind of the start. And you kind of see, you know, Marie still looked good back then as she does now. You can tell I was a lot skinnier back then, but it was kind of funny and cool to look at where we were 9 years ago. And like I said, since then, it's been 22 songs with respect to the Canucks. A lot of them, Canucks songs, a lot of them, 22 songs working with Marie, and a lot of the songs actually working with the team itself. And then that doesn't include Seahawks songs, Whitecap songs, NBA songs, and other songs that we've done together. So I have a whole playlist. I'll link to that as well, but I'll link to the whole Canucks song playlist, but I'll link to the fact that that Marie and I, our very first video from November 2011. It's a wonderful, wonderful way to see how far we've come in 9 years. So we hope to do a song soon to kind of help get us through this negative news, this waiting period, to give us some hope. So we're going to be talking about that soon. In fact, Wednesday night, I was supposed to go to the game with Marie because she was going to be singing the anthems before the Tampa Bay Lightning game. What a great game that would be. And I was going to go as her guest. So we were going to write the song or talk about the song then, but we'll have to figure out another time to do so. So for today, I just want to share just how blessed I feel that I'm able to do these musical collabs with Maria Huey. We've known each other for 20 years through church. And more important than her being a wonderful musician and singer, she's an awesome friend. She's a friend to my wife Gail and our three kids, always supportive of our family. And we love her. We love Chris and their son Ronan as well. So very blessed to call them good friends of ours. And Marie, I'm not sure you're going to watch this, so I'll just text you and tell you that I talked about you for a few minutes. Looking forward to the next one for sure. And thank you for your friendship and for your trust in making these songs together. So there we go. I'm going to link to our first video. I'm going to link to our playlist. And if it comes out the next day, I will link to the Sportsnet 650 interview as well. Thank you for watching today. Not really much to comment on, but you're welcome to comment if you if there's a particular parody song of mine that you remember that you liked or that you didn't like for whatever reason, or you write your own parody song down below, pitch an idea to me, I'll be open to that as well. And then don't forget, tonight we are going to be on YouTube Live. That's not Marie and me, but me plus some of my family members. I'll start off and then I'll bring a couple of them in. So join me tonight, 10 o'clock on YouTube for my weekly live stream bump from last night. Leave a comment below. I'd love to read, react, and reply. Hope you enjoy your day. Like I said, big news expected from both the provincial and federal governments, and we'll see what happens. Be safe. Take care of each other. Love each other. Love one another, and I will talk to you soon. Subscribe if you like to. Like this video if you like to. God bless. Go Canucks, go.